The Bible has a lot of illustrations about a person sleeping. Not laying in bed sleeping, but just sleeping and not aware of the blessings and the opportunities in life. In John 11, verse 11, it talks about our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep, but I am going there to awaken him. Well, there have been many times that I have been dead to some situation and I needed to be awoken, and I was by God. And if I was gentle with myself, I didn't have the school of hard knocks to have the awakening. I could listen to God and I could answer the call to new life. I could awaken. Even death could not withstand the call to life that Jesus gave to his friend Lazarus. Jesus prayed a prayer of thanksgiving to God and then called Lazarus, "Come out." And Lazarus walked out of his tomb alive. And we know that every day a Spirit of God within us gives us a wake-up call to life. And we come out of our own tombs. Perhaps it's from in back of the wall of excuses that we've made for ourselves. And we answer the call to living, not with dread, but with enthusiasm, with joy, and with purpose. We truly want to be an expression of God's love to others. And this desire leads us to answer the call of God, the call to life. We answer the call and we become more because of picking up the receiver and saying hello, the receiver of the mind. And we answer the call to prayer and we dedicate some time every day to this sacred activity of prayer so that we can stay receptive and in communication. This is a communion of the soul that awakes us to our own spirituality. So we answer the call to life and we are awake, and we're awake in every way, spiritually, physically, and mentally. And we realize that when we were asleep, we were blind to the opportunity and the good that was all around us. When we're awake, we are receptive to what God has planned. And what God has planned is always very, very good.